I welcome you, all of you, to this keynote talk 5 of the International Conference on Computing, Communication and Learning. Our keynote speaker has already arrived. So I request Professor K. Ramesh sir to introduce our keynote speaker. Sir, please.
A very good afternoon to all of you. It's my privilege to introduce this session's keynote speaker, Professor Vincent Joe Puri. Professor Vincent Joe Puri has received his PhD in computer engineering at Polytechnic of Milan, Italy in 1989. He is full professor in computer engineering at University of Milan, Italy since 2000. He has been associate professor at Polytechnic of Milan, Italy, and visiting professor at the University of Texas at Austin, USA, and visiting researcher at Georgia Mission University, USA. His main research interests are artificial intelligence, computational intelligence, intelligent systems, machine learning, pattern analysis and recognition, signal and image processing, biometrics, intelligent measurement systems, industrial applications, digital processing architectures, fault tolerant cloud computing infrastructures, and Internet of Things. Original results have been published in 400 and plus papers in international journals, proceedings of international conferences, books, and book chapters. He is fellow of IEEE, Distinguished Scientist of ACM, and senior member of INNS. He is president of the IEEE Systems Council from 2020 to 21 and IEEE Research Region 8 Director Elect 2021-22 and has been IEEE Vice President for Technical Activities since 2015. IEEE Director, President of IEEE Computational Intelligence Society, Vice President for Education of IEEE Biometric Council, Vice President for Publications of IEEE Instrumentation and Measurement Society and IEEE Systems Council, and Vice President for Membership of the IEEE Computational Intelligence Society. He has been Editor-in-Chief of the IEEE Systems Journal 2013-19. He is Associate Editor of the IEEE Transactions on Cloud Computing and has been Associate Editor of the IEEE Transactions on Computers, the IEEE Transactions on Neural Networks, the IEEE Transactions on Instrumentation and Measurement, and IEEE Access. He received the IEEE Instrumentation and Measurement Society Technical Award in 2002 and the IEEE TAP Hall of Honor 2019. He is Honorary Professor at Obuda University, Hungary, Guangliang University of Petrochemical Technology, China, Northeastern University, China, Muraran Institute of Technology, Japan, Amity University, India, Galgotias University, India, Chandigarh University, and Bihar, India. So thank you very much for joining us to give the keynote speaker. Now, I hand over to Professor Vincent Puri.
Good morning, good afternoon, namaste. It's really a great pleasure and an honor for me to be here with you today and talk about the use of artificial intelligence in the modern infrastructure for computing and storing, in particular in cloud, fog, edge computing, and the Internet of Things. In this talk, we are going to see specifically how we can use these technologies in a smart way to enhance the quality of the application, the services we are providing, as well as to improve the quality of the management of the infrastructure themselves. Cloud computing is the modern infrastructure that is used more and more in a pervasive way by companies, by the government agencies, by the researchers, infrastructures, in order to create applications and store the data that are useful for the goals of these entities. The big advantage that we have with the cloud computing is the fact that we can choose the specific resources that we need on demand. We do not need to buy and manage in advance all resources, even if we are not strictly needing them at that time. And this type of use of the various resources drastically reduce the cost of the ownership and the use of these resources for the various applications. In the last few years, the various clouds, started appearing on the market, both for general purpose services, especially with the big players of the market, but also with specialized clouds, which allow to offer specific services tailored on specific needs of segments of the market. Many very specialized companies provided components, services, applications, which really can boost the use of the cloud and simplify a lot of the development and the deployment of a broad variety of applications in a different in different areas of the market. The multi-cloud allowed to bring together the various offers in order to pick the most convenient one for the various services which are needed, and then the user can combine these services in a comprehensive perspective to build its own application. But the problem is that we need to choose the services. As user, we need to know the market, we need to know the players, we need to pick the services and combine them in order to support our own application. And this may be a significant burden on the shoulders of the users or the designers of the application. The recently, the modern approach to this is given by the Cloud Federation, where there is a broker in the center, so that the various requests of the users are actually understood and managed directly by this broker, which take into account the specific needs, preferences, constraints of the users and of the applications, and then pick the most appropriate components, the most appropriate cloud service in the federation, distributing the use on the various clouds in a transparent way for the user.
Professor, kindly share your slide. Actually, it is not shared.
Yes?
Kindly share your slide. It is not visible, actually.
Let me do in a different way. I will share the entire screen.
Yes, yes.
And I hope that since I was sharing the slides, let me try in a different way.
Yeah, now it is visible.
Yeah, thank you. I don't know why it was not visible before. Yeah. Okay, can you see it now?
Yeah, please continue.
Okay, so what we need also to take into account is that in many applications, the amount of data which are generated or needed at the peripherals may become very, very huge. And as a consequence, we need to consider if the communication bandwidth is enough to bring the data back and forth in the network from the peripherals or to the peripheral up to the application which is running in the cloud. If this is not, if the bandwidth is not enough, what we can start considering is to move a part of the computation and storage nearer to the sources of the data. And as a consequence, we can introduce some fog nodes nearby the sources of the data that can collect the data, start a preliminary processing, and then deliver this material, the results of this analysis to the entire application in the cloud for subsequent operation and eventually storage. If the amount of data is really, really huge, we may need to move a part of the computation directly on the peripherals, on the edge. And this leads to introduce the edge computing model, which allows to really extract the relevant information which is needed by the application and which is needed to be transferred to the network in the cloud. Internet of Things, on the other side, is the other modern infrastructure which is defining standards for interconnection, for protocols, for data transfer, which really simplify and standardize the interconnection with the peripherals for our applications which are running in the internet. We may have specific servers running the applications, or we can combine the Internet of Things model in order to run more application, more complex applications with a demanding workload and store many data. We can combine this infrastructure with the cloud model so that we can have a distributed structure with the peripherals typically managed by the standard models of the Internet of Things. And then eventually the data can be processed locally if the bandwidth is really limited and our need is really huge, or transferred to eventually a fog node locally, aggregating the data coming from a group of peripherals and reducing the traffic to the central application, which is running in the cloud. This distributed architecture and the use of distributed services actually really can make pervasive the use of this type of infrastructure and definitely support the use of the modern applications. On the other side, let's see how we can benefit from artificial intelligence in this type of architectures for our applications. There are many opportunities offered by many companies to build the applications without having really a detailed, deep knowledge of the artificial intelligence technologies of and specifically of the computational intelligence technologies, which constituted the subset of the artificial intelligence focusing on the subsymbolic computation in neural network fuzzy systems and evolutionary computing, for example. These tools are actually kind of black box with a limited number of parameters which need to be tuned so that the user can select the type of processing and just tune a few parameters, which does not require a deep knowledge about the technology, how it's structured, how it's working, and how to eventually configure the very fine details. This simplifies really a lot the use to non-expert users who have only a limited knowledge of these technologies. But if we need to build more complex applications and we do not want to use to develop the entire approach by ourselves, But we wanted to rely on components, on services which are already available, tested, and tuned in the network. We can rely on many companies which are providing this type of support, simplifying the use of artificial intelligence in our own applications. We have components, services which support the collection of the data, which support the interaction with the peripherals, so that we can focus only on the data when they have been extracted. Then we may need to enhance, clean the data, and there are companies which are offering these tools in the perspective of an appropriate use with the artificial intelligence techniques. We need also to run services, applications, algorithms which are based on the machine intelligence, on the artificial intelligence techniques, to extract the knowledge to devise the most appropriate approach to solve the problem. And as a consequence, many companies started to make available this general purpose algorithm, which can be appropriately tuned on our specific application. This obviously may require some more detailed knowledge about these technologies. On the other side, the companies started offering also services which make available some models in a simplified way. Then when we need to build our own application, we need also to build the interaction with the user. And as a consequence, many companies started to offer graphic interfaces, smart interfaces, based on the natural way of interacting of the humans with touch, voice, vision, so that the interaction will be much more natural with respect to the typical computer-based human system interaction that was in use since many, many years nowadays. If we have a specific area in which we wanted to create a solution based on artificial intelligence, specialized companies with not only with the background, with the knowledge in the area of artificial intelligence, but also in the area of the specific use cases, started to make available the some bundles, some services, some components, focusing on the specific use cases, solving the entire specific use cases, so that we can pick one of them and use it in our own application, tailoring the parameters to our specific needs. Some companies also started to work in a broader way to satisfy the needs of a specific sector, industrial sector, so that the companies working in this sector do not need to pick various components to build the applications in an heterogeneous way, but they can choose the solution provided by one of these companies, the most appropriate one, to manage the entire set of activities of that specific industrial sector. Then there are companies which are providing data mining tools, which allow to structure the analysis of the data to extract the knowledge. And they provide also knowledge extraction infrastructure with the appropriate databases, eventually heterogeneous according to the specific type of data that we need to manage, and performing the knowledge analysis and extraction by using ontologies and semantic rules. There are also companies which provide a comprehensive infrastructure, software infrastructure for data analytics, starting from the collection of data, from the collection of heterogeneous data, the representation in the appropriate data repositories with the appropriate tools for searching and analyzing this data. There are also components which allow to extract from the data the relevant information, compress the data, reduce the complexity, and provide the appropriate views for the better understanding of the users. This data, these views, are then presented to the users by using the appropriate reporting tools, which allow to configure how to point out the critical aspect to attract the attention of the operators, of the users, on the critical aspects. And then, to simplify the life of the users, it's possible also to create some monitoring view so that in real time we can collect the data, analyze the data, and trigger the attention of the operators, of the users, on critical situations which really demand quick attention to address the detected problem. Finally, this type of infrastructure offer also the model, the interface for decision support systems, so that the user can approach the amount of data, extract the knowledge on which he or she can base the most informed decision. And these infrastructures, these decision support systems really allow to view the data from the different perspective according to the needs of the decision makers. Then we have the Internet of Things, which can be viewed as a distributed architecture for intelligent processing. So we can distribute in the infrastructure some agents, some artificial intelligence components, which analyze the data locally and extract really the relevant knowledge which is essential to take appropriate action in the infrastructure. But how we can use the artificial intelligence not only to build the applications, as we have just seen, but also to manage the infrastructure themselves, the cloud fog edging computing infrastructure, as well as the Internet of Things infrastructure. There are really many, many opportunities for doing this, which has been explored both in the literature and in the practice in the market, and have been really successful. We can, for example, use fuzzy systems to support the specification of the service level agreements so that the user is not forced to know the language of the cloud in order to define what she or he may need. But the user can use her own words in the natural language to specify the need, and then by using the fuzzy system models. And then with the use of the machine learning, we can extract some knowledge to guide the choice from the previous cases, which has been seen similar to the one required by the specific instance, required by the specific user. If we have several clouds among which we need to select the most appropriate one to support our applications, or when we are in a multi-cloud environment and we need to understand where to deploy the various components of our application, the artificial intelligence has been shown very effective in order to map our task on the virtual machines of the various providers by considering a variety of objectives. So we can perform also a multi-objective optimization, for example, take into account the quality of the service, the type of the services, the performances, and the price. And neural network has been shown effective for the cloud selection, the fuzzy system for specifying preferences and characteristics, the evolutionary computing for the multi-objective optimization, and machine learning techniques, including the statistical one, have been shown effective for analyzing the data analyzing the request and extract some guidance from previous cases. When we have selected the cloud, then we need to deploy the task in the multi-cloud or in the cloud of federation, and we need to map according to price, services, performance, quality, and so on. We need to map where the individual components are allocated in the infrastructure. For this, neural network has been shown effective for the mapping, and the fuzzy system, again, for specifying preferences and characteristics, while the optimization has been shown effective by using the evolutionary computing techniques. Nowadays, we tend to build the applications not to rewrite everything, but to look for services which have been already developed, tested, and used, and as a consequence, improved in accuracy and quality by many users. These services allow actually to simplify writing our own applications. And the problem which we have in this case is how we select as designer the services that we need. To do this, in particular based on ontologies, we can use the artificial intelligence to perform this mapping and to reuse the knowledge that we can extract from previous cases so that we can speed up the choice and better tailor the needs to the specific services which are offered on the market. Another problem that we have when we have decided where to allocate the various tasks is to allocate the resources to the tasks in a static way when we start the application, or dynamically when the various applications are actually evolving. For this, we need to choose the virtual machine and associate the resources to the virtual machine, which is going to run our task. Also in this case, this mapping and the specification has been shown effective by using the artificial intelligence techniques. Then we need to place the virtual machines on the various nodes of the infrastructure. And also in this case, the mapping and the association of the various services have been shown very effective by using the artificial intelligence techniques. During the operation of the system, we have an evolution of the activities, and we may have an evolution of the needs of the storage and computational needs of the various activities, of the various tasks that we deployed in the cloud infrastructure. If we want to ensure the appropriate workload for the various nodes, we need to have the ability of predicting the performances, how the various tasks that we deployed in the infrastructure are actually working, which is the demand in terms of resources and data of these tasks, so that we can detect in advance, if possible, if some nodes of the infrastructure are going to be overloaded, and as a consequence, the ability of satisfying the needs, the requirement of the various applications can still be fulfilled. Prediction has been shown effective with the neural networks and fuzzy logic. We may need to balance the workload in a dynamic way. For example, if we see that some nodes start to be overloaded, we may need to move a part of the activities on another node of our cloud infrastructure in order to limit the workload and, as a consequence, ensure the required performances. And we may need to do this dynamic reallocation of the tasks in a real-time approach. Neural networks have been shown effective for detecting possible unbalancing and perform the mapping of the virtual machine. Fuzzy system for specifying the possible constraints about the balancing workload. to provide guidance, guidelines to define when and how to act for the possible reallocation. And the evolutionary computing has been shown effective to perform the new mapping. Similarly, we can see in the Internet of Things infrastructure that we need to allocate the resources, eventually to perform dynamic reallocation. And also in this case, the artificial intelligence techniques have been shown really effective to achieve these goals. And to achieve the goal of workload prediction, and as a consequence, to support the load balancing to detect the possible critical situation. And to perform the dynamic reallocation of the various activities. Energy management is another important aspect that we need to consider both in the cloud and in the Internet of Things model, since we need to reduce the cost for the energy. We need to reduce, as a consequence, the cost, the impact on the cost of the services for the user to make the services more and more usable. On the other side, it's important to reduce the use of the energy to limit the impact on the natural environment and be conscious from the point of view of the impact on the climate. Energy prediction is therefore essential in these perspectives, and artificial intelligence has been shown very useful to understand the consumption of the various components of the various applications, and as a consequence predict the behavior of the system of the various architectural components in the perspective of the energy usage. So that is possible to perform eventually a reallocation of the activities without impacting the performances and the quality of the service, but in order to reduce the energy which is used by the infrastructure. It's useless, for example, to have several nodes with a little workload, which implies anyway a significant use of the energy for running these few applications, while we could consider moving part of the applications, combining the nodes that are supporting the various applications, so that consolidating the application on a limited number of nodes, we can actually switch off the nodes which are not needed. And as a consequence, find a trade-off between the energy consumption and, on the other side, the performance and the quality of the service. We may need also to configure the infrastructure when we design and deploy the Internet of Things infrastructure, as well as the cloud infrastructure. We may need to understand the possible networking that we may need to support the application with the appropriate bandwidth. Also in the design of the infrastructure, the artificial intelligence has been shown effective for classifying the operating status and optimize the infrastructure themselves, also by using the experience collected in the previous cases. We need also to ensure the functionalities in time. And as a consequence, we need to manage the possible fault and ensure resilience so that we can ensure the dependability of the applications on the infrastructure, with possible duplication of critical tasks, with the ability of switching on and off the various nodes in the infrastructure to use alternative routing paths in order to ensure the continuity of service, the continuity of collection of the data, processing, storage, the continuity of the service of the entire physical infrastructure. For this, we may need also to adopt the dynamic reallocation of the activities. We need to detect the possible presence of faults And if we want to act in advance, we need to predict the possible occurrence of critical situations, of faults. Neural networks, fuzzy system and evolutionary computing have been shown effective for the mapping of the activities, for the dynamic remapping of the activities, as well as for the neural network, the fuzzy system and the machine learning for the prediction of this type of situations, so that we can work in advance, preventing the system to enter in a critical situation, to have the failure appearing, the possible service discontinued for a shorter time in order to allow the reconfiguration. If we act in advance, we can avoid this downtime for the services. Security is also a very important area in which artificial intelligence has been shown effective for intrusion detection, malware detection, for the analysis of the trust, so that we can deploy our applications in sufficiently trustable node according to the criticality of our applications, as well as for the analysis of the possible threat, so that we in the system, so that we can predict the security, and as a consequence, we can move our applications in the nodes which are sufficiently secure from the point of view of the application. We can predict the vulnerability of the various nodes, of the various connections. Another important aspect that in which the artificial intelligence has been shown effective is the management of the infrastructure from the point of view of observing and act on the critical situation. If we have the operators who have to look to a huge amount of data coming from the management systems of the infrastructure, they may be overloaded or overwhelmed by the amount of data. And as a consequence, they may not be able to take quick actions when very critical situations may occur. The monitoring systems for the cloud and Internet of Things infrastructure allow to analyze the behavior of the infrastructure and bring the critical situations directly to the attention of the operators. Fuzzy system has been shown effective to specify the parameters and the constraints of the behavior which need attention, as well as neural and fuzzy systems for and machine learning for detecting the anomalies and trigger the attention of the operators. Cloud fog, Internet of Things pricing is also very critical, since if we do not set the price at the appropriate level, we may not be able to attract sufficient customers. We may not be able to make the services available to a broader audience, so that many more applications can benefit from the use of these technologies. From one side, we need to provide a sufficiently low cost for the services to enable the users actually to buy these services and to make them palatable for their own applications. And on the other side, we need to provide sufficient revenues in order to invest in the maintenance and the expansion of the services offered by the cloud, to maintain the quality of the services, and as a consequence to provide a better service to the customer, and obviously to sufficiently remunerate the initial investment that was done to build the infrastructure. Neural network fuzzy system machine learning has been shown effective to analyze the trends in the market and the user demand in order to identify the balance between the cost and the price that the companies can offer. And evolutionary computing has been shown effective in this multi-objective optimization. So the basic contribution of this talk is actually related to the fact that we are working in the area of intelligence more and more, and the applications really, and the management of the infrastructure really need much more intelligence nowadays. For this, artificial intelligence and computational intelligence has been shown very effective to support both building of smart applications as well as in managing this type of infrastructure. With this, I would like to thank you. And if you have any question, I will be very happy to answer.
Yeah, any participant having any question, you can ask to Professor PUD. Professor, I have one question actually. You have mentioned about service level agreement, and service level agreement, we need to standardize it. Otherwise, there are so many issues. So what are the research challenges with respect to standardization of service level agreement?
Well, yes, this is an aspect which is very important in order to simplify the use of this type of infrastructure. This is a problem that is not strictly related to the use of artificial intelligence, is much more related to the simplification of the offer of the companies in order to allow non-expert user to pick the most appropriate service in an easier way, to choose the company offering the service in an easier way. Having standardized models for using the cloud infrastructure or the Internet of Things will allow the user to compare the various offers.
Yes.
So this is very important. The artificial intelligence, if we are not reaching a complete standardization, and this may be a choice of the companies, since they may want to offer something more, maybe more memory at the same price for our virtual machines and so on, or some plans which allow to reduce the cost the more we use the various services. Obviously, this will make it more difficult to have different standardized plans, since the various companies will try to compete to offer something better with respect to a minimum standardized plan, set of plans. And as a consequence, I believe that even if we are going in this direction to simplify the complexity of the market and make the comparison easier, on the other side, the companies will tend anyway, as we have seen in other sectors, think, for example, mobile computing or the various offer on the TVs. We need anyway to have tools which allow to simplify the comparison also in the case of this kind of offerings which may start from a basic standardized model, but then they add something. So how we value the different additional opportunities. And as all of us have seen in many applications with the cell phones providers, for example, or other type of application, the competition is very, very strong and is not always easy to to understand which is the offer that is more appropriate for us. Take into account that this kind of offerings also are changing in time. And as a consequence, we need to have this analysis performed when we actually need the specific service.
Yeah.